So where?
Okay, I'll tell you. Just give me 1 minute. Okay, how to get to the forms, okay? Okay, now I'll be sharing the screen. Okay, so those who are having, okay, so okay, just see, can you see it like this? A teams are there. So when you click on the teams will appear to you, your class will appear to you. Okay, in that Mathematics 9DG. Okay, Mathematics, you have the channel. Just click on that. Okay, and as the form will be uploaded, you'll see it like this. Fill 9 yes, mathematics form. Yes, you'll see this one in your channel. Okay, and as you click on it, it will appear like this. This form is currently not accepting responses. The reason is the form will start at a particular time. For example, your examination starts at 9:30. Okay, so this form will open at 9:30. Okay. Just give me a minute. Okay. So you have to go to your teams and then the channel. Okay. You will as well get the direct link. Okay. So in channel, you will always find this one. Okay. Now, give me 1 second.
Sir, please repeat.
Okay. 1 minute. Okay. Have you seen our teams tab? And I can show in teams?
Yes, sir.
Click on that. Everyone click on that Teams icon. Okay. You will see 9th Daisy Sandmai Seeker. The team you will see. As you click on that. Okay. You will see many channels below that. You're all the classes channels. Mathematics, Biology, Chemistry, English, Geography, Hindi, History. Those all you will see. So for example, today is Mathematics examination. Okay. So you click on channel Mathematics 9DG. As you click.
Sir, can you repeat? My network is lacking.
Okay. Have you click the tab Teams? Have you clicked the tab Teams? Okay, in that, go to channel Mathematics 9DG. Click on that. You will see like this. Fill 9th mathematics. Okay, 1 minute. Let me add one more. See here, you see form like this. As you click on the channel, fill mathematics one. Are you able to see?
Yes, sir.
Yes. As you click on it,
yes, sir.
As you click on this form, you'll see this form is currently not accepting responses. It means it not yet started, okay? It not yet started, okay? In mobile, see how you're going to see, okay? Let me stop sharing and show you on mobile once. Okay. This is how your calendar will appear. Yes. This is how your calendar is going to appear. Click on Teams. Teams. Okay. Now you see 9 days in general, biology, chemistry, English, geography, and mathematics. Three hidden channels as well. So you can click and you can get all the channels, okay? Mathematics, click on mathematics. Okay. Now you can see, added a new tab for this channel. Here is the link, fill 9th mathematics. Click on that. And it will appear like this. Okay. The form has not yet started, okay? Now I'm going to start the form and you see how it will appear, okay? Just a minute. Okay, I'm again sharing the screen.
Yes, sir.
Okay, this time see here, 9th mathematics, you all know where you have to click. Okay, here is the tab, fill 9th mathematics. And you'll see it will appear like this. 9th mathematics, attempt all questions, time 5 to 5:30. Submit form by 5:30 p.m. Always date the what is given in top, okay? So it means by 5:30 you must press the submit button, okay? So you have to enter the name, then your section, okay? There may be possibility I won't put name, okay? Because it can be automatically recorded as well, okay? So there may be possibility some teachers may not put name or section as well if they are taking the single section test or examination, okay? So just go accordingly, okay? If name is not there, don't worry about that, okay? So tomorrow I'm making one more test in that name won't be there and section won't be there, okay? So enter your name, whichever section you are having, you belong, just click on that, easy, okay? These two fields are
so now required.
Yes, listen here, no, not now, just live. See here, okay? You can see the red star, red asterisk mark. Okay, it means that these fields are required. If you don't fill these required fields, it won't get submitted. Form won't get submitted. So these red marks are there, red asterisk mark. Name you can see above that. This means these are required. Like name you must enter. And section as well, you can see the red mark. That means it has to be submitted as well. Without this, the form won't get submitted. Okay, without this, form won't get submitted.
So we have to do it now?
No, don't do it now. Afterwards, you can practice this one. Afterwards, okay? And then, rationalize. These are the questions. Take the correct answers, okay? And at last, there will be submit button. Submit, okay? So understood?
Yes, sir.
So what is required? That these fields, your name and section, they are must. They are must to enter, okay? As you see the red marks anywhere, that means they are must to enter. Without this, you won't be, the form won't get submitted, okay? Now in mobile, let me show you. Okay. So you are going to click on Teams. You have clicked on Teams, okay, and then select mathematics. So fill mathematics form. It will appear like this. So always see it on top. Attempt all questions. Time 5 p.m. to 5:30 p.m. Stop. Submit form by 5:30. It means by 5:30 you have to submit. Okay. As it you see 5:29 or 5:30, submit it. Okay. name, it's required. These are red marks, these are required. Okay, then your section. Okay, then find the value of A and B. Okay, 4 points means the question consists of 4 marks. Okay, find the value of A and B and then take the correct answer. Okay, rationalize the denominator. This question is of 3 marks. This is the question. This is the expression given. You have to rationalize it. Rationalize the denominator. Again, rationalize the denominator. Afterwards, submit. Yes?
Sir, we have to fill this mock test.
You don't have to fill it now. After your examination, classes are over. Okay? Whenever you are free, do fill it. Okay? This is simple
mock test. Sir, what is time?
There's no time limit for today. Okay? By 5:35, by 5 p.m., please submit it. Okay? Whenever you get the time. By 5 p.m., submit this test. Okay? And as well, you will see the marks for this test. Okay? But
okay, sir.
The examination with the school is later we are going to take. You know, it will appear. First, it will appear the form is not accepting responses. It will open on the particular time. Okay? And you won't be able to see the marks as well.
Unit 1 test will be taken same.
Yes, it's the same way.
Sir, in same way we have to do like this exam, unit test.
Yes, this way. Yes,
so, but as this, well. But this exam is not asking that password.
Password, see, yes. This is not asking password. Why? Because you are already logged in. Okay? You are already logged in. You are already logged in.
Sir, in unit test, you have to put password.
See here. Oh, okay. See here. It may ask sometime. For example, you are logged. If you have installed the Teams app, it may not ask password. The reason is you are already logged in. Yes or no?
Okay,
we are already in Teams app. And we are clicking those particular tabs like Teams. And then we have clicked. Okay. Now see here what may happen. This link may be shared. Just Javadhan, please mute yourself once. Okay, so see here, this link may be shared in WhatsApp or may be shared in Teams app, like class-wise notes or online examination. That will be told to you, okay, where you can get the link as well. You can directly click the link and can enter the form, okay? You can directly click the link and can enter the form as well, okay? So like many teachers are providing you link in WhatsApp. Yes or no? Many teachers are providing link in WhatsApp.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
As you click that, sometimes it may open in Teams app or mainly it doesn't open in Teams app, I think. Okay. As you click that, it may ask your username. Yes or no? Sometimes. It may ask your username. You all have your username. If you don't have, just text me. I'll send you the username. Password, around 43 students are there in class. 37 students I have got the passwords. So if they forget, I can forward you. But 6 students are still remaining. Okay? 6 students are still remaining who haven't submitted the password. Okay? So if you have submitted the password, I can immediately send you the password. Username I always have. Your username is saved with me. Okay? One PDF file is there. I'm having all the usernames. But password, since you have all changed, so I don't have those passwords. Around 36 or 37 students, I have got the passwords. Remaining haven't sent me. So those students, please send the password to me afterwards, after your classes. One Google form I already sent you on the in WhatsApp group. So fill that form, okay? So whenever you forget the password throughout the year, I can forward you immediately. Or I'll see what happens if you forget the password. If I don't have that, so I have to forward it to the school or to the concerned person. And it depends on that person to reply. So it may take 1 day, sometimes 2 days. If it may take 1 month as well. It has taken. Abdul Azim Khan's password, I got it very late. I keep testing and I haven't got. And one more student have forgotten. His password I got in 4 days. Yesterday I got in 2 hours. One student has forgotten. So it depends on the other person. Whenever the other person is free, can provide the password. So it's better to always keep it written somewhere. You can save that or you can send me. I'll have it saved here. So whenever you forget, you can get from me. Okay. This is clear to all. So examination, see what you have to do. Appear today anytime you are free. Okay. This is completely okay. appear anytime, but you all must appear. If you are prepared, it's fine. If you're not prepared, it's fine. But sir, attempt the, yes?
Sir, I think that in last question of mock test, there is wrong options.
Which was the last question?
Sir, rationalize the denominator of
so, 1 upon 3 minus root 7. 1 upon 3 minus root 7.
Yes, sir.
Do it again. Do you get the correct answer? It's correct answer only.
Sir, correct.
Which? Yes, it's correct. You may have got an issue like this. You may have got 3 plus root 7 upon 2. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Can I write like this? Root 7 plus 3 upon 2.
Yes, sir.
Because addition follows commutative law. Whether you add 1 plus 2 or 2 plus 1, they are going to give the same result. Okay. I have especially put this like this. That's why. Okay. Okay. So appear this in test. You appear only once. So don't worry whether you get the marks. It's completely mock test. Just to get you be familiar with the how the examination can be taken. Okay. Is this clear? So you can get the it form here. Okay. And soon more information will be provided to you. So don't worry about anything. Okay. This is clear to all regarding test?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So we can start the class then. Okay, so we were discussing congruency. Okay. Tomorrow as well, I'll be taking one more mock test, okay, and that will be around. Okay, what time should we take? 5:30, okay? 5:30, it will start at 5:30, okay? At 5:30, it will start, okay? Tomorrow, I'm going to take one test. It will start at 5:30, okay? I'll be giving half an hour. Up to 6, you have to submit, okay? So, that will open at 5:30 tomorrow, okay?
Okay.
So, today, we are discussing congruency. Congruency means we have to prove that two triangles, they are of same shape and same size. Okay. Same shape and same size. Same size means same area. Okay. So how we are going to prove? For example, this is one triangle provided. This is other triangle provided. Okay. A, B, C, P, Q, R. Yesterday we have seen if two triangles are congruent, it means corresponding sides are equal and corresponding angles are equal. So how many angles are there? Three angles. Three pairs will be there and three side pairs. So we have seen AB equal to, for example, AB equal to PQ, BC equal to QR and CA equal to RP. Okay. These were the three sides, and angle A equal to angle B, angle A equal to angle B, angle B equal to angle Q, and angle C equal to angle R. Okay. So when two triangles are congruent, these hold true. That is, corresponding sides are equal, and angles opposite to the corresponding sides are also equal. Okay. So, for example, this side is equal and this side is equal. This side is equal to this side and this side is equal to this side. Okay. If corresponding sides are equal, it means corresponding angles are also equal. So, opposite to AB, which angle? Angle C. opposite to PQ, which angle? Angle R. It means angle C is equal to angle R. Okay. Or if it is given, angle C equal to angle R, it means side opposite to those angles are also equal. AB equal to PQ. Okay. Incongruent triangles. This is clear. So to prove two triangles to be congruent, these six things must hold true. Okay. These are the requirements we have to prove. Okay. To prove two triangles are congruent. Okay. So see here, if we prove some of them, that is minimum requirement. See here, either we can prove all of them, or if we prove just few of them, that would be the minimum requirement to prove that two triangles are congruent. Okay, just few of them among them. Few of them, if we prove, then we can prove that these two triangles are congruent. Okay, so what are those minimum requirements? First, we are going with SAS. That means if we prove, just we prove two sides and one angle. Which kind of angle? Included angle. Two sides and one angle. Then we can say that two triangles are congruent. So we don't have to go for these six things. Rather, if we go for just three things, we can prove that two triangles are congruent. Okay. So SAS theorem. So to prove two triangles to be congruent, these are the minimum requirements. First, we are going with SAS theorem. So in SAS theorem, we have to prove, for example, this is provided to you only. Okay. Okay. You are being provided with two triangles. And it is being told to you that AB equal to PQ, BC equal to QR. It is being told to you. And angle B equal to angle Q. These three things are given to you, for example. Okay. Can we prove that these two triangles are congruent? So, SAS theorem, first you will figure out. First you will see what are given to us. Okay. So, which theorem we are going to use? For example, this side is equal to this side is given. This side equal to this side is given. And this angle equal to this angle is given to you. Okay. Now, you have got to know that I'm going to use SAS theorem. We are going to use SAS theorem. Okay. So, how to proceed? So, first you'll be writing the triangles. If you are writing ABC. ABC. It means which side we have written first. AB. Then BC. Similarly, we have to write here. PQR. PQR. What is given to us? AB equal to PQ. AB equal to PQ. BC equal to QR. BC equal to QR. Okay. So we have written the corresponding vertices. A corresponds to P. B corresponds to Q. And C corresponds to R. Okay. This convection we usually follow. Okay. If examination you don't follow, it's fine. It's fine. No issue. You'll get the marks. But still we follow this convention. It becomes so easy. Why do we follow such convention? So that everyone is very familiar that this is how we have did that. By seeing just the two triangles written in this form, we can tell which vertices are corresponding vertices, or which angles are the corresponding angles, and which side are the corresponding sides. You can see as well, angle A corresponds to angle B, angle B corresponds to angle Q, angle C corresponds to angle R. Okay. Or AB corresponds to PQ side, BC corresponds to QR side. Okay. Or CA corresponds to RP side. Understood? So that's why we write in this way. Okay. Now, okay. So we'll take first these two triangles. Okay. All the sides and angles we write this side. Of first triangle we write here. Second triangle we write here. Okay. So what is given? AB equal to P. So see here, we start from AB. And here, we have to start from PQ. Don't write QR. Okay. QR, it is right to take QP. Don't write QP. It is right to take QP, but still, this is the convention we usually follow. So A corresponds to P, B corresponds to Q. So we started from here, AB. Here as well, we start from PQ. Okay. What is the reason? For example, it is given. So we'll write the given. Whatever reasons behind this, we'll write here. given or anything, okay, that will be the sides of the parallelogram, maybe whatever reasons may be, we can write from here. Okay, AB equal to PQ. Next one, what is given? You may write angle first, you may write side first, it doesn't matter. Okay, it doesn't matter. Okay, it's fine. I'm writing first the side, then BC side. BC of first triangle equal to QR. Okay, it is also given. Write the reason. Okay, then angle ABC. Since here it's single angle, you can write directly B. Okay, but if having many more angles at this vertex B, so we have to be specific. That is, we have to write angle ABC, angle ABC, angle PQR. Okay, so what I have taken? Two sides, one angle. Yes or no? Two sides, one angle. Which theorem I have used here? Side, included angle, and the side. It means I have used SCS theorem. So at last we'll write triangle ABC congruent to triangle PQR. And reason we will write SAS theorem. Understood? So we have proved two triangles as congruent. And for example, in question it was given, we have to show that AC equal to PQ. If question says, has given that this side equal to this side, this side equal to this side, and we have to show AC side equal to PQ, PR. So what we are going to do? First, we have proved them to be congruent. As they are congruent, every corresponding side and every corresponding angles will be congruent. That is, they will be equal. So at last, we have proved congruent. It means, therefore, AC equal to PR or CA equal to RP. Okay, that's up to you. CA equal to RP. Okay, what reason you write? CP, CTC. What does it mean? Congruent parts of congruent triangles are congruent. It means congruent parts of congruent triangles are congruent, means they are equal. Congruent parts of congruent triangles are equal. Congruent parts, these are parts, are equal. Or what more we can write? This angle will be equal to this one because CPCTC. This angle will be equal to this one because of CPCTC. Understood SAS theorem? Everyone have understood SAS theorem?
Sir, how can we say that this is congruent?
Okay.
Because so only two sides are given.
See, yeah, only two sides are given and one angle is given. Okay. Okay. How we can say that? Okay. So, for example, so how you can draw the triangle? For example, BC is given 5 cm. You have drawn BC. Understood? Now this angle is given of 30°. Okay. Draw an angle of 30°. This is no more than 30°. Okay. This is, for example, this is 30°. Okay. Now AC is given of 4 cm. So you are going to mark an arc of 4 cm. Yes. Join them. Are you going to get this triangle? Can you make a triangle when two sides and one angle is given?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no? Okay, similarly, yes, second, sir. Same dimensions are given. So won't they be same triangles? Even though third time the side is not given, but still you can draw. Even these two angles are not given, but still you are able to draw the same triangle. All the students, if these only 3 quantities are given, all the students are going to draw the same triangle. They are congruent. Understood? So what is the minimum requirement to draw a triangle? Two sides and one angle.
Yes,
included
yes.
Angle. Yes or no? Which kind of angle? Included angle. So if we prove, okay, if we show that, like for example, you and your friend has drawn the triangle and these were the parameters given. And now I'll say if this side equal to that side, corresponding side, this side equal to corresponding side, if angle. If your friend has drawn with the same dimensions, then your both the triangles are congruent. Understood now? Now this is not given, these are not given. But if you compare with the protractor, yours and your friend's, you will get the same angles. Okay? If you compare this one and this, you will get the same angles. Understood now? So how many quantities are required to prove? Just 3 quantities are enough?
Yes, sir.
Why should we go all the 6? Maybe all other quantities may not be given in question. For example, in this question, it is being ask that prove AC equal to PR. We have to prove that AC equal to PR. How we are going to prove? That means we have to prove that these two triangles are congruent by the given quantities or given parameters. Okay, so these three things are given only to us. If we can prove that these two triangles are congruent, this and this, we can tell that AC will be equal to PR. Reason? CPCPC. If they are congruent, it means they are going to overlap. It means their corresponding size, overlapping sides and overlapping angles are equal. Have you understood this? This is SAS theorem.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. Next is, for example, this time, two angles and one side is given. ASA. Two angles, one side. Which kind of angles? Two angles and which kind of side? Included side. It is between the angles. Okay. Again, we can. Okay. First, we'll draw the triangle. Okay. Okay. So ASA, it means, for example, these two angles and this side is given. These two angles and this side is given. Okay. If, for example, two angles are given, that is 30 degree and 50 degree. Okay. And the included side, that is side between them, these two angles, is given of 3 centimeters. Can you draw the triangle? First, you draw a line of 3 centimeters. Yes or no? B, C, or mark. At this point, vertex B, you will make it, you will construct an angle of 30 degree. At C, you will construct an angle of 50 degree. You have got the triangle?
Yes, sir.
All the students will get the same triangle or not?
Triangle.
Yes. So this corresponds to this, and this angle corresponds to this one. Okay. So see here, I have used double arcs. So it means this angle is equal to this angle, and this angle is equal to this angle. Angle A equal to angle Q. So if I prove, so again I'll be using those things. This time, two angles are right. What I'm going to write? Angle B, that is angle ABC, equal to angle PQR. And second, I'll write BCA. BCA, and I think QRP, I'll write. QRP. These two angles are equal and side cycle. BC equal to QR. Okay. Now see here, you can see in the figure what I have used. ASA. Yes or no? ASA. It is included side between these two angles. Yes or no? So by ASA, these two triangles are congruent. Here I write this triangle and here I write this triangle. These two triangles are congruent. Understood? And now rest things,
yes,
will
sir,
be equal. AB equal to PQ, CA equal to RP, angle CAB equal to angle QR, QPR. Reason? CPCTC. Understood this all?
Yes.
You all have understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So those students who haven't submitted the passwords, please submit it. Okay. So that whenever you forget, I can provide you. Still 6 to 7 students are remaining. Okay. Tomorrow I'll name them as well in class. Okay. So you will figure out who, whether you have submitted or not. Okay. And few students have submitted twice, thrice, 4 times. That's okay. No issue with that. Okay. Okay. So we end the class here. Thank you all. So today,